at this pile of potatoes. I've tried sales, I've tried coupons. Don't our customers want home fries anymore?
Hi, Busy. Is everything okay? You seem super duper stressed.
Stressed? I panicked! Our potato sales are plummeting. People just aren't buying them. What's the potato problem?
Well, maybe because no one can see them behind that big display of rocks.
These rocks are rocks, Waffles. These rocks are potatoes.
They definitely look like rocks. And they smell like rocks. Hey, what do you think, Mochi? You want to try them?
What? Nobody wants our potatoes. Haven't they ever eaten french fries off the floor?
Steve, not everyone eats off the floor.
At this rate, I'll have to cancel our next order. No more potatoes at this store. Ah. But what'll I tell Mrs. O?
Moch, we need a cool display to make the potatoes hot. You ready, Mochi?
Mrs. Obama, I just don't understand. French fries, mashed potatoes. Why aren't people buying them? Potatoes are so insanely delicious.
Yeah, that's true.
Right?
That's true. Make some good points there.
We gotta get to Magicart.
At this rate, we'll be stuck with these potatoes forever.
Hey, Mochi. Ready for the world to fall in love with this rock?
Potatoes. It smells like the earth.
Are you sure this is a potato? I'm pretty sure I just have a piece of dirt or a rock in my hand.
Yeah, Papa.
The potato has different shapes. One day I found a potato that looked almost like a cross. It looks hairy.
I think a potato is beautiful. Because when I try it, I taste beautiful flavors.
It's
beautiful if it's been peeled. But if it's not peeled, it's not so cute.
I think potatoes are kind of ugly, but taste great.
It's beautiful.
It's a little bit ugly.
I think it's pretty.
Ugly.
It's pretty.
It's a bit ugly, but delicious.
Okay, Magicart. We have to help our customers see how potatoes are cool, not boring.
But between you and us?
They're just boring rocks, right?
Boring? Have you seen the potatoes they've been eating in Peru for the last 8,000 years?
No?
Well, get ready, because we're about to meet Manuel Choque Bravo. Chefs call him the Potato Whisperer.
Hey, Moji, what's a potato whisperer?
Prepare for landing in Peru!
Sacred Valley!
Manuel, how do we make people more excited about potatoes? They're kind of boring, right?
Waffles, I'll show you some potatoes that are definitely not boring.
Gracias.
Look. Okay.
Whoa, look at the pattern on that one, Mochi.
It looks like if I draw a picture with a marker.
But it's in a potato.
These potatoes are really delicious when they're cooked. The potatoes are natural. They grow in the Andes in Peru.
That one is just completely red. Each one looks like its own painting.
And today, there are over 5,000 varieties of potatoes.
Amazing! Manuel, how do you even grow a potato that cool?
There are some foods, like tomatoes, that come from seeds. But the potato is its own seed. Can you believe that?
What?
Claro.
What?
Claro.
What are you telling me? Are you saying that the potato grows itself?
You dig a hole in the ground with a pick, and then you plant the potatoes. Then you cover it with soil. Then, we wait about 5 months for the potatoes to start popping up. And then we start harvesting them.
Wow!
These are the coolest potatoes I've ever seen. But are people really gonna fall in love with them, Mochi? 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 Mochi?
Amor mio. Eres el ser.
Mochi.
Que amo
Mochi. Hey, Mochi, look.
Huh?
Guys, I'm going to give you these potatoes for my friends, Pia and Cristobal,
yeah,
so that they can teach you how to cook them.
Okay, sure, we could do that.
Come on. Here. Oh, I'm sorry, Mochi.
Oh, Mochi, sorry, bud.
We're going to talk about Antoy and potatoes.
Antoy?
No. You know, that name is kind of hard.
Antoine.
There's a guy named Antoine Augustin Parmentier. Antoine lived in France in the 1700s. That's a really long time ago. The whole town abandoned potatoes because they thought they make people sick. And growing them was against the law or eating them. Antoine felt really sad because he loved potatoes. He would say, you should like it because it's healthy and easy to grow, and you can eat them because they're a vegetable. So to prove it, Antoine called his friend Benjamin Franklin, and he said, you want to come to my house to try my new potato dishes? Benjamin Franklin said yes. So we came to France and tried his dishes, and he loved them so much he went back to the United States of America to tell how wonderful potatoes were. And then Antoine went to see the Queen Marie Antoinette, and he said, I've got you some pretty bouquet of potato flowers. Antoine told her to wear them because they were so pretty. And she's a fashionista, and I love fashion. Potatoes became so popular, people changed their mind against the law that it was okay to eat potatoes and grow them. So whenever you're eating a french fry, remember Antoine Augustin Parmentier.
Okay, so we've got Manuel's potatoes. Oh. They look cool, but will Manuel's friend Pia be able to cook them?
Hold on to your taters, you two. We're headed high in the Andes to Chef Pia Leon's award-winning restaurant, Mew. I'm pretty sure she can take your tubers to the next level. Hope you're hungry!
Oh, hi. Are you Pia?
Yes, I'm Pia.
I'm Waffles, and this is Mochi. Manuel said we should bring you these potatoes.
Perfect timing. We're going to start to build the guatia. Let's go.
Great.
Oh.
Boom. Looks like they're digging a pretty deep hole. What exactly is a guatia anyway?
So the guatia is a traditional way to cook potatoes here in the Andes. So the idea is to build like a pyramid with a lot of balance. It's not easy.
Mochi, yeah. I think it's like an oven made of clay and soil.
Why do you like cooking them like this?
Because here happens all the harvest. So the idea is to share a nice time between working and eating potatoes.
Yeah.
So we are ready. We're gonna start to build a fire.
Okay, let's do it, Mochi. Whoa.
Light the guatia. Potatoes. They're just chucking them in the fire.
Oh,
oh no, it's collapsing. Oh, wow. Yeah. To put out the fire and finish cooking the potatoes, they knocked over the entire guatia. Looks like the potatoes are fully cooked and cooled down. Let's dig them up. Cristobal,
do you have a favorite way to eat potatoes?
Yes, come with us and we'll show you.
Oh, okay. Come on, Mochi.
I'm gonna show you our own way to cook potatoes, the same potatoes from the guatia, the favorite dish of Cristobal.
We're gonna prepare a potatoes stew. Really simple, but with a lot of flavor.
We grew the potatoes, we cooked the potatoes, and then we're gonna eat the potatoes. I can't wait.
So here in Peru, we always eat, you know, with onions, garlic, and then we have an amazing pumpkin here, local. So we just add the pumpkin and the potatoes. We love yellow chili.
Oh, yeah!
The idea is to use all the vegetables we have here in the farm. So we have some fava, some corn. I like to finish with a little of milk to make it more creamy. And we're gonna put some cheese. That's it.
Now we wait. Whoa! That looks so good.
You have to try.
We do?
You have to.
I guess. We'll have to try.
Ready? ¿Qué tal?
So, do you like it?
Yes or no?
Wow. Who knew potatoes could be so delicious? How do you say delicious in Espanol?
Delicioso.
Delicioso. Is there anything else you can tell us about potatoes that will blow people's minds?
Crees en el espacio.
Yes. Do you know potatoes can grow in the space?
I like mashed potatoes. Mashed potatoes are one of my favorite foods. And french fries.
Roasted.
Baked.
Potato chips are delicious.
I can't explain its flavor. And the thing I like most about potatoes is when it's fried. I like that.
It's yummy. I think it has a white flavor. I don't know.
It's quite sweet and nice.
It's salty. As long as it's not raw. No one likes it raw.
Guess what, Magicart?
What's up?
Potatoes can grow in outer space.
Oh, I knew that.
Oh, of course you did.
In fact, scientists are figuring out how to one day grow potatoes on Mars. Remember, plant one in the ground and a bunch of little copies will pop up. Actually, I know a guy in Los Angeles who knows something about growing potatoes on Mars.
Ooh, Matt Damon?
No. A real scientist. Let's go hang out with NASA engineer Bob Ackford-Dowsey, whose team put the Curiosity rover on Mars!
Oh, yeah! This scientist looks like the perfect person to make our potato display a little more out of this world!
Los Angeles!
Whoa. Wow. Oh, hey!
Hey.
Oh, hey, Bob Ack.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Well, I'm Waffles, and this is my best friend, Mochi.
Hi. Oh. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. We want to grow potatoes on Mars to make our potato display really special. Is it true that you can grow potatoes, like, in space?
Yeah, you can grow them in space.
Whoa!
So far, we've grown them in a low Earth orbit, so that where the space station and the space shuttle will fly.
So what you're saying is that if two friends were to grow a potato on Mars, it would be the coolest potato in the world?
I mean, not just the world, the galaxy.
Well, why are they so easy to grow in space?
Well, you see, like, potatoes actually have a lot of the ingredients they need with them in their little tube form, and they don't need a lot of light to grow, so it's a pretty good food if you're gonna travel to Mars and turn it into a battery.
A battery?
A potato battery. Uh-huh. What do you guys say we try to build one?
Yes.
You need a nail, and you need some wires. That's, I'm just gonna stick that in there. Here is a penny. So we've got most of what we need.
It's a tiny little light bulb.
You guys ready to see if this potato battery lights up this little light bulb?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Let's light this spud.
All right, one, two. Look at that. Just a little glow from that light bulb.
Good job, potato.
You can eat it and you can power things with it. Pretty handy.
I didn't think a potato could have that potential.
Yeah, I mean, the potato is so amazing.
Hey, Mochi. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? To the Magicart.
How did they get in my house?
Of course this is a good idea.
If we grow potatoes on Mars, people will come from all over to see them.
While technically able to make it to Mars, your electric range is currently
at... It would be the most amazing potato display in the history of... ever. Space time!
Now approaching Mars!
Time to plant the first potato ever on Mars. Let's plant this bud. Okay, potatoes in the ground, just like Manuel showed us. And there. Okay. Now we wait for it to grow. I spy with my little eyes something red. Yep. All rock. Good job, Mochi. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Today, how I wonder what you are. Papa. This is gonna take a while.
Hello, I'm Tan Franz from Netflix's Queer Eye, and today I'm here to meet Spud. He needs help bringing out that inner beauty. That's where I come in. Hello, Spud.
How do we do this? Do we hug? Do we kiss? Okay.
Today, we're gonna bring out your inner beauty. It's that simple. Let's get going. Are we thinking country because you're in Idaho? Do you mind if I mess up your hair?
Yeah, I like that for you. You clearly got a shape for hats to die for. Here's the thing, I don't want to hide too much of you because you're so hot potato. So how about just a tux? Thoughts? I know, I was thinking the same thing. Listen, if that tux can't make you feel the way you want to feel, I think we just have to accept the fact that, yeah, you're perfect just the way you are. Like, it does not matter what I've tried to put you in, nothing looks as good as this looks. You're perfect. Best look ever.
I spy with my little eye something potato-y.
Mama.
You're right, again. It's a rock. Did Manuel tell us that buds take 5 months to grow?
Mama.
Well, I didn't bring a change of underwear, did you? I think we failed. Let's go head home, Mochi.
Mama.
All right. At least we learned a lot about potatoes, huh, Mooch?
Meow.
Yeah. Even if the potato didn't grow on Mars, it still went to Mars.
Mm-hmm.
How many potatoes can say that? None. Mission basically accomplished.
Meow.
Take us home, old buddy.
Meow.
What? Magicart?
Meow.
Take us home, old buddy. Ugh. Magicart, wake up! Mooch, what's going on? What? The battery died? How did that happen? Oh, right. Because we drove all the way to Mars. How will we get back to the store? Mochi, what if we're stuck on Mars forever? If only we had another battery. Yeesh.
Mama.
Mochi, you're a genius. Yeah, just like we learned. We can use the potato as a battery. Oh, sure hope this works. Yeah, we did it. We don't need to change potatoes to make them amazing. They're already amazing. Take us home, Magicart.
Approximate trip length, 195 million miles. Let's go!
Potato power!
I appreciate your concern, but, you know, we've got to give people their space to grow.
You think I've been too harsh on her?
You might be boxing her in too much. You got to learn how to work things out with coworkers.
Look, it's a bird, it's a plane, it's a waffle.
Here they come.
Hi, Mrs. O.
Hi.
We went to Mars and the potato saved the day.
You went to space?
What?
Oh, yeah.
We thought we had to make the potato awesome by bringing back a Mars potato, but Mrs. O, can I tell you something?
Yeah.
It was already awesome.
That's an important lesson to learn. You know, sometimes we make the mistake of thinking that what makes something special is what's on the outside, like how big someone's ears are, or whether they have fur, or whether they're pink or blue. But what you realized is what's important is what's on the inside, and that there's real magic in the inside, right?
Yeah, you're right.
The first time I saw a potato, I was like, ugh, it looks like a rock. But then we found out that potatoes can be super beautiful. And when we roasted potatoes in an old-fashioned watia, we used them to make some really delicious food. But it was hearing about space potatoes that took us to Mars. And when we got stuck, we used the power of a potato battery to get home.
Uh-huh.
Potatoes definitely aren't rocks. Yeah. But potatoes definitely do rock.
Seems like you guys are a couple of potato pros.
And for that, you both have earned your potato badges in honor of your wonderful work today of discovering what's special on the inside. Congratulations once again.
Well, I'm glad that you both know how great potatoes are, but how do we make sure our customers know?
Oh, busy. Leave that to us. Yeah.
Oh, dear.
I can't believe I ever thought that you were unspecial somehow. That you were boring and ordinary, but that was before I knew what I know now. You can do anything. You can grow almost anywhere. So to anyone who's listening, I want to declare. A boring, ordinary potato. That's not what I see. 'Cause boring, ordinary potatoes are magical to me. Good night. You're not super flashy. You don't need to scream and shout. So I just had to look a little closer to see what you're all about. You can fix a light bulb. You can power cars. You can be a power source. You can even grow on Mars. A boring, ordinary potato. That's not what I see. 'Cause boring, ordinary potatoes are magical to me. Cause boring, ordinary potatoes are magical to me. Good night, potatoes.